After watching many trash anime, I decided to stop for a while and look for not popular anime shows from the 1990s. I'm a big sucker of 1990s animation, and that's what made me a fan of Japanese animation in general. One of the shows that nobody talks about and is simply great is a show called The Responsible Captain Tyler. This show is so underground that even I found that there is a dub in my mother language, which is kind of strange because my local anime community is very nostalgic with the anime they like. Even the opening title sequence screams 90s all over the place with the singer appearing in the intro. This show is freaking amazing. After laughing my ass off with this show and what I consider one of the golden gems from the 1990s, you get across this section of my anime list, and that's what brings us to this video's creation. I wanted to make an AMV as my next video, but that must wait. Just remembering that this exists makes me go angry. There's a so-called spin-off sequel, whatever this piece of putrid vomit garbage you want to name this obscenity, called The Responsible Galaxy Tyler. The first question with this show is just why? Why does this exist? The greatness of Captain Tyler is shared with this crappy show also called Tyler. I will not waste any more time and let's go to the review. So what is this one about? The story already infuriates me with the first seconds talking about the greatness of Lieutenant Commander Justi Ueki Tyler and how his achievements helped during the time he was alive to restore peace into the galaxy. And with that, the show is set somewhere in the future, after the period the Responsible Captain Tyler events took place, and we meet our protagonist called Banjo Ueki Tyler. Don't you dare say Justi Tyler's catchphrase! The main protagonist, Banjo, plays the banjo. Very clever show, very clever. And he is a garbage collector that later sells it. It is just like the creators of this show are doing, with his assistant Yamamoto. This robot Yamamoto looks like a carbon copy of QT from Space Dandy, but it's more square instead of round. Although the junk does not have the traits that made the original Yamamoto also a good character. Later they go to this spaceship and find someone sleeping in a chamber, and that chamber contains the Empress of the Ralgun Empire, Goza 168, or Azalin for short, and she's surprised that Tyler is alive. One thing I must state from this, the gags in the show are dull that you want each episode to be over. And the worst part, it is one of those 3-minute short series, but you feel that 1 second is 1 minute with this piece of excrement. And also, they put reference because putting a reference of another franchise will make the joke even better. But no. All the gags are hideous, like this one on the evolution of Yamamoto. Is this a Pokemon and Star Wars reference at the same time? Moving on. Later they go to a bar to steal a spaceship, and they find this pirate inside the ship. Then on another scene they got trapped in a desert planet. Literally, there's a desert on that planet, and they camped there until I noticed something when I got to episode 5. On episode 5 there's no animation. 3-minute shorts, and on one episode there's no animation. Just pure dialogue and some drawings slap on the screen. This made me wonder if my thoughts were correct, and I was right on why this seemed familiar. Moments later, I found the sad truth. This abomination was directed by none other than the talented mind behind Ladyspo called Hiroshi Kimura. I said it on my Ladyspo review that this guy has made tons of garbage and I was planning on reviewing some of them, but to imagine that I was going to find his name related to the Captain Tyler franchise made me go angry beyond belief. Now the question is not why, the question is how. How this came to existence. This episode has to be his beta test for Ladyspo because it is the same. Just someone talking, but on Ladyspo he made the so-called effort of animating the girl's mouth movement. And you know what the worst part is? This was animated by the studio company called Seven, and Studio Seven is famous because they develop hentai and has one of the best acclaimed hentais out there by the people who love that type of content, but not me. We have the best of both worlds, a director who barely knows how to direct animation and believes that moving the camera up and down is directing, and a studio that knows how to make good hentai. With that info dump, it explains why there are shots like this one on the ending credits. They should stick on doing hentai instead of taking established franchises that shouldn't be touched at all. At this point they should have made Rule 34 Captain Tyler and I wouldn't be this mad like I am right now after watching this. But no, this is not even the boiling point of this mess. The next episode makes a little summary of the events that happened on the Responsible Captain Tyler, and they are brought to you by this animation. What is this animation? Just how can this be given an approval? Just look at the side-by-side comparison and tell me what looks better. This is why you don't give the license of a good show to a hentai company, for God's sake. And more ladies pobeta test for you in this episode. If there's any fan of the upcoming show called Mao-sama Retry, then beg for the best. Kimura will destroy it for you. He's directing it. This guy should have a restriction order to any anime studio and not have the authorization of directing ever in his life. After this, it is revealed that this guy is watching YouTube videos to find about Justi Tyler's history and he wants to become the new emperor of this galaxy. And you want to know what's next? There's a filler episode. I just can't express my rage with this one, but this clip summarizes my thoughts.
Are you crazy? Are you out of your mind?
How is this possible? I can't take it anymore. Let's go to the final episode.
次回で最終回! なんかあっという間だったね! 最終回だからって周りのみんなは気合い入れまくりみたい!
I am not! This shit is insufferable! Well, here we go, the best attempt of being family friendly on this channel. I didn't swear on my videos, but the breaking point is here. I can't stop. Fuck this show! After these horrendous events, they go to Frozen's Ice Castle and they decide that this will be the fortress of the new Ralgun Empire. But the bad guy with a robot army comes to fight them and claims this so-called empire. Hey Kimura, stop copying other franchises. You have done it with Macross, you have done it with Dragon Ball, and now you're copying Mega Man's Dr. Wily? Can this end already? Later, a space and time vortex is opened out of nowhere, and the villain falls into it. But for some stupid reason, Banjo decides to save him, and he unites in the stolen spaceship crew, and the pain is finally over. I am going to say this. You people should be ashamed that you tried to ruin the greatness of the Captain Tyler franchise. Sometimes I believe I hit rock bottom with the shows I have reviewed on this channel, but holy moly, this is one of the worst by far. One of the things that makes this fury grow is that this was made in 2017, just 2 years after the release of this video. Can someone really explain this? No. The better question is, who was this aimed for? To all fans of the series? To attract new fans? To substitute the legacy of the original Captain Tyler with this shit? That's the only conclusions I can get from this. This shouldn't have existed, and ever, never, never give the license to a good show to a hentai company. Heck, even they had the balls to create an official Twitter account about this show, and there's an email to send questions, so I'm going to end this video with this message to them. Dear Galaxy Tyler production team, never in your life make animation at all. It is disrespectful for those who really are animators. So please, stay away from an animation company. Best wishes and take care in whatever you do except in animation. Best regards, Elketsen. Well, this is everything for today. I hope you enjoy it because I didn't. You can make a recommendation on bad anime and subscribe to check out my next torture. This is Elketsen. Take care in whatever you do and skip this one and just go watch Irresponsible Captain Tyler. And erase from your memory that these nameless animated sequences even existed from your mind. It will be tough, but I will do that. See you on my next video. Goodbye.